Hello there, everybody, and welcome to a new series. This is Grounded, and this is the first episode thereof. It just released, and I thought, you know what? We're going to start this series so you can enjoy this game with us. We are miniaturized. Arthodoidy, yes, the aphids, right up there. We'll be talking about it as we go along. We are going to be seeing quite a lot of weird and wonderful creatures. So the whole thing here is this. Well, this game was early access until now, and it has now been, released completely with a little bit of overhaul. But notice this baseball. We are shrunk. Now, of course, this has been, you know, played out this comparison with Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, because this is a very different game, but it definitely gives off those feels. So there's a very strange machine there. There should be two others. There's another one there. And somewhere in the distance, way over there, there would also be one over there. Right. So, we are going to be exploring the world of Grounded, everybody. I've been looking forward to this game's release for so long. And here we are. Finally, it has been released. Now, the idea is, this is a survival game with some crafting elements and, you know, overall quite a weird and wonderful thing. The story is now finished. Up until now, the story hadn't actually been finished. But we are going to be finding out how on earth we got to the point where we are now. Ooh, little mushrooms. Now, of course, one has to be careful. Can't just eat mushrooms. Especially not this type. This, yeah, this is Amanita muscaria. This big one over here, the fly agaric. My scout training doesn't have a merit badge for this. No, it doesn't. Doesn't have a merit badge for eating Amanita muscaria fly agaric mushrooms. So this one will give you quite a bit of a trip, apparently. But it is toxic, and that's why it kind of gives you a trip. But the little ones to the side would not be Amanita. I'm not sure what those little mushrooms would be. But in any case, obviously, we're not going to go much into that at the moment. I can hear a weevil running around here somewhere. Somewhere. They're quite vocal, these little weevils. We'll be talking about insects and how they communicate as we go along, of course. But the objective here is to follow the instructions at the top there, explore your surroundings, which we are currently doing, and locate the source of the signal. So we have just located the signal, and here we go. A field station. So we now have to use the resource analyzer, which is this little contraption right over here. And this is how we... Logic dictates that there are probably more of these stations around. Yes, there should be. I'll find some clues. Or someone. So this analyzer here will give us our recipes, like pebblet spear over there and the pebblet axe that we'll be getting by using the, or analyzing first the pebblet and then using that in the construction of whatever we are making. There we go. We are now analyzing the sap over here, which would be a resinous type of sap secreted by the plant, usually used to prevent infection. So that's, I guess, why we can use it in the fiber bandage as well. Right, so we've analyzed a few things here. This is just the start of the game. I can hear an ant, I think, as well. I have played this game for quite a few hours, so thankfully I know a little bit about what to do. But of course, as soon as we get into... Hello, ant. Hey, a common example of the Formicidae family. Formicidae, yes, that would be the ant group. Now, of course, we can chuck a pebblet at it. And he is upset with us, but he is also stunned. And then we just kind of bash him with a rock because we can. And now he's running, of course, to get help. Not a good start. I was hoping that, you know, I would first attack him with an axe or something. Anyway. We'll carry on and hunt some ants as we go along, of course. There we go. So this is a mysterious machine. We are going to be getting back to it in a moment. But first, we're going to just quickly craft something. Just making sure that there is nothing dangerous around. There's the ant. However, this ant isn't unhappy with us. We're thankfully not under attack by it. Okay, so yes, we can change from first person to third person, depending on, you know, which one you prefer. The third person does allow us to get this nice little peapot bowl haircut, or see that at least, but if we don't want to see that, we're going to be in first person mode for this game. I really enjoy first person mode, just really makes you feel like you are living the miniature life. So we're collecting a whole bunch of things here, and I think now it would be time to craft something. So we open the crafting by just going tab, go to craft at the top here, and I want to create a little pebblet spear, so might as well just craft that, And then in inventory, we've got it on plot number one. It's going to allow us to equip it and at least have something to poke things with. Now, there is a net as well. We're going to have the net for the bow. And I missed that.
Tower to net, say intentions. Your flight path is not cleared.
Definitely not clear because there's a spear coming your way in a moment. Hey, stop bumping me, you little bugger. There we go. In this case, it really is a bugger because it's actually a little flying thingy. Okay, where's my spear? There we go. There's the spear. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so I guess let's start with the story at least so that we can then move on to the main things that we can see around. There's a little aphid there as well. Okay. So, of course, we are on a mysterious machine. Somehow, we got parachuted from the top, ended up over there somewhere. So, if we're looking on the map, quite a big yard that we are going to be looking at as we carry on in this game. Oh, wonderful. So, we started out around here somewhere, I guess. We then made our way to the, probably there, we made our way to the baseball, we've been to the field station, and now we are here at the mysterious machine. And I guess, I see a blinking light, I've got to push it. Yes, it definitely did. Oh, okay, so there, of course. That one there. Damaged, probably. Yes, it does. And that one intercepted. Okay, so we must chop down this grass blade over here, which to do that, we need an axe. We need another pebble. I'm going to just quickly pick up a little pebble. There we go. And we need crude rope, of course. So we can just make crude rope because we have more than enough material for that. And then let's just craft an axe. And we need to chop this one over here. There we go. Great stuff. And to make sure that it doesn't come back, we can, of course, chop it like that. Right. So this one now is functional, that one there is functional. There is one more that we would need to go and fix, and that's that one over there. Let's just quickly head, or start heading in that direction as well. Of course, always a good idea to get some more food. And stab something. Right. So a little bit difficult to see, but weevils characterized by those long snouts. And you see that little snout there with the antenna at the front there? Oh, a whole bunch of them. Yeah, hello. Murder. Where are you? Come back here. There we go. Another one dead. Okay, that one's still running. Cheers, little one. But characterized by this long snout. Now, most of these can fly, although there are some species that also cannot fly. But the majority of them are not flightless. The majority of them can fly. Hello, ant. I see you. Okay, anyway, we are on a mission. We've got to go and go to that one tower that isn't functioning properly. I think it's this one over there. Okay. Now, we do need water as well. On the left-hand side, you can see there we have got water or thirst and hunger. And we need to make sure that we don't, you know, die in the process. Now, I'm playing on mild because it is more important for me that you guys get the information on the invertebrates and what life is like or would like be like in the undergrowth than to be super realistic. Of course, if you want more challenging gameplay, you can, of course, change to a more severe difficulty. But as for me, I like at least being able to survive and give you guys a bit of a show. So I'm going to just play on the easiest difficulty. There is, you know, once you get used to it, you can play without a lot of difficulty. You can actually play the higher difficulty levels as well. But for now, just going to have a bit of fun in the undergrowth. And I am just jumping here from leaf to leaf on the thistle plant to get some thistle thorns over here, or thistle needles, so that I can make some arrows later. Now, the thistle here looks like it's a Canadian thistle, possibly. A weedy type of plant. There's another one way in the distance there. And we do have them here in South Africa as well, invading a lot of our areas as well. The particularly disturbed soils, they would do very well in. Now, where is our tower that we need to go to? That one there. Okay. They would do quite well in very disturbed environments as well. Okay, so we are heading up there. Before we head up, I do need a parachute as well. There's a thingamajig, a dandelion right over there. What on earth is that sound? Oh, I know what it is. There, stink bug, somewhere to that side. Okay, not ideal. Don't want to go near them at the moment because we don't have anything to deal with them yet. Oh dear. Okay. Let me just stay out of their way. There's another dandelion over there. If we look there, there's a little dandelion fluff at the top there with the seeds at the top of the plant, of the stem there. Let's just quickly chop that down. There we go. Okay. Now, we can get ourselves a lovely little parachute. And we can equip that as our accessory. There we go. Dandelion tough. Now, whenever we fall from a great height, at least we can use the little parachute to not die when we fall. And there we go. So that... Oh, hello. Hello, little guys. Now, you can block, and if you do it right, you actually don't take any damage at all. However, I did not perfect block that. So these are mites. So let's have a look there. So there's one there. The lawn mite. Now, mites are arachnids rather than insects. Even though they look like little typical creepy crawlies, they actually have four pairs of legs instead of three. Let's just have this little guy jumping over there. There we go. Okay, so as you can see here, one, two, three, four pairs of legs instead of three. Looking for more coming. And they also only have two body segments. Somewhere there is another one. Maybe one, that one over there calling, but there may be another one. We'll just have to keep our eyes out. Thankfully, they don't do too much damage. But the mites, or all the arachnids, have got the cephalothorax, which is the head and top body, and then the abdomen part, so two body parts. Insects, on the other hand, have three body segments. They've got the head, the thorax, and the abdomen, which are the three body parts. And we're just going to walk over exposed wires, which seems very, very safe, and actually just go up here, making sure that there are no lawn mites up here. Doesn't look like it. Oh, and there we go. Parachute. Saved ourselves there. Okay, so there's another one over here. And now we are going to go into the cave, and the best idea is to have a torch as you go in. You need another sprig, two rope, and three dry grass chunks. So we can do that without difficulty. We just need another sprig and some dried grass. So here's the sprig. Just going to collect some more for later as well. And then we need dry grass here. Now, the resources here, the dry grass and the normal grass, would respawn. So as long as you don't cut down these bottom stems here, it should respawn over time, which makes it quite nice and renewable. You go about this in the right way, you don't have to worry about running out of resources, really any, ever. Okay, now, we are ready, basically ready. Let's just quickly craft the torch over here. And the fun thing is, we can have both a torch and a spear equipped, so we can have a look and stab as we go in. Now, previously, before the most recent update, there used to be quartzite in this cave here, which was extremely useful when upgrading weapons and armor and things like that. However, that has been removed, but I'm wondering whether that means that you can find... Oh, hello. The new materials... Hello, come on, jump again. Here we go, blocked you guys. Whether you can find the new materials that's now used in upgrading armor and weapons. I think one could probably find that here now. There you go. So let's just quickly fix this. Okay, so we have finally fixed it all. We can come back for that later. And we need a hammer to go in here. And we can't craft the hammer yet because we have not yet analyzed the pebblets. Okay, so we're going to go and do that in a moment. Okay, in terms of our quest, we've got three up there. The main one, of course, go home, is investigate the machine further. The whole objective is that we want to, and let's just put away our torch, we want to return home. If you look at the introduction of this game, it will tell you that there have been a number of children that have gone missing. And that's obviously bad. and we are one of the four most recent ones that have gone missing. Let's just go to analyze this as well. And so our objective is we want to return home. But this is quite a long mission. And so we're going to focus on the other things there. It's pick and find and eat some food, pick and eat a mushroom. So I think that's going to be two things at the same time. And then find water, which we're going to do in a moment. We're just first going to analyze this. You see there on the right hand side, it uses solar charge. And then that comes back as we let time pass. Okay, so we have now leveled up, which means we get a whole bunch of recipes that we hadn't unlocked up until now. We now are able to make it. Let us now analyze Mite Fuzz, which should give us the arrow recipe. Yes, there we go. I'm just checking whether there's anything new that we can make. Nothing new from that. Not that I don't know of, at least. And then Nat Fuzz should give us the bow that we can then make. There we go, Sprig Bow, the basic first thing that we are going to, first range weapon at least, that we are going to be making. Okay, now as you can see on the right hand side that it is recharging slowly and it's going to take a while for us to get, we'll be able to use it again. Okay, we're going to look at the spacer safety test in a moment. Let us first just go in and eat the granola bar, which will also restore some health. Okay, and we can't do that while we have carrying something, or while we're carrying something. Okay, let's have a look here. The spacer safety test. So this is by Dr. Wendell Tully, which is the main scientist that's probably, I guess, responsible. And we're going to find that out as we go along, whether he is or isn't. He's probably responsible for getting us down to this size. Oh dear. Okay. So he says power fluctuations are within an acceptable range. The machine itself continues to operate as expected. Weatherproofing of the platform components is holding up quite well, so that's quite cool. There are plans to actually bring weather into this game. I don't think it has been released for version 1.0, but I'm pretty sure that weather will come in at some point, at least in the future. So the pylons, that's the one we've repaired now, however, are a finicky trio. Maintaining the beam angle requires regular obstruction removal, chopping down that grass, basically. The yard is simply too alive for precision instruments. Oh, Euclidean space, you fickle mistress. Interesting. Okay, so he's a bit of a scientist. He's a scientist there, and he has gotten us basically small. Reminder check in beginning cell diagnostic before end of day protocols. So the machine that we are going to be looking at now, let's just check nothing else in here. No. The machine that we are going to be looking at here is the machine that's responsible for making us big again, I believe. As far as I recall, that's the objective of this thingamajig over here. So now that we have removed that grass, we have stabilized that one. Let's have a look. Let's activate. Okay, let's see whether we go big or go boom. Let's see. Oh dear, there we go. Oh, okay. It seems we go boom instead of big. Oh, drat. Ooh, okay. That's bad. That is the base of an oak tree over there. Yeah, it is our bad beat. We blew up something over there. Investigate the oak tree explosion. So that is going to be our objective for the next episode.
The nose.
So there we go. Weevils. Wouldn't really be sniffing around like that, but they do use the antennae to actually sense molecules and stuff in the air, of course. So the antennae on the weevil nose, usually a little bit more forward on the nose rather than as it is here. So there we go. But that's a little weevil. Mostly herbivorous, so we really have nothing to worry about them. And in this game, they also are passive. So they will not attack you, not even if you go and stab them in the gut. Like this. They are harmless little things, but good eating for us. And that, everybody, is where we are going to end today's session. So thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed the first episode. This is going to be our new series. I am wrapping up Ancestors, which will most likely be recorded tomorrow and released later this week. But I hope you enjoyed today's first little session here in Grounded. If you enjoyed it, leave a like below and also comment what you would like to see me do as we go along with this series. Until next time, everybody, stay safe. I will see you all soon.